GitHub is without question one of the most important platforms you'll use as a developer, whether you're in data or software development, it doesn't really matter. GitHub provides an amazing way for teams to collaborate together on development, share code, version control, automate your CI process, along with a whole bunch of other things. GitHub allows you to do a lot of things just strictly on their UI, but in this video, we'll focus on getting you started locally by following the first step, which is installing Git on your local machine. We'll follow along this quick start documentation here. And as it says here, at the heart of GitHub is an open source version control system, VCS, called Git. And if you're gonna work with this, you need to have it installed. So let's go ahead and install it. I'm on Windows. I'm just gonna bring open my command prompt and just type in Git just to show that it is currently not on my machine. If it was, we'd get some information there, but it's not. Step one, download and install the latest version of Git. Let's go ahead and open this. You can select your operating system. For me, I'm on Windows. And it should automatically pop open. If not, you can select one of these options here. So after it finishes downloading, go ahead and open that file. And it'll get you to this setup window. We're going to cruise through here. Here, adjusting the name of the initial branch. This is a relatively recent change. Traditionally, the master branch has been called master, but some teams are renaming this, and GitHub is giving you the option to decide what you want that to be. You know, maybe you want it to be main, trunk, development, whatever. We'll keep it as a default. I'm going to move forward with a lot of these options here just to get us going and install. And I'll just let it do its thing here. And we can see it's putting this in our C drive program files directory. We don't need to see the release notes. Not going to launch this, finish. So I've opened up here a fresh command prompt. I closed down the one I had before. And now if I do Git, here we go. We have a bunch of options here. So Git is successfully installed on our machine. Step two, set your username in Git. Now the username is what's going to be associated with any of the commits that you do, meaning any changes that you want to pass on to GitHub and for your teammates to see or just to log, it's going to be associated with a username, and this is how you can set that. One important thing to point out here with the username is that the Git username is not the same as your GitHub username. Just because we're setting your Git username, which is what we just installed, is Git. GitHub is the website with this platform where you'll need your own username and password here, which is technically separate than what you're setting locally as your Git username. Just want to clear that up. What we'll do here is copy this, paste it here. And what we're doing here is saying git config and using a global flag to say user.name. And we're not obviously doing Mona Lisa, and I'll just do mjcon. And now we can confirm it by running this command here. We'll take out the actual name and just see what it is. And it should return our name, which is mjcon. So now it's set. Next, set your commit email address. And again, this is used for as you're interacting with things, it ties it to you and your email address so that you can get notified of different things that are happening. You can go ahead and set this on GitHub directly and adjust some settings to make it private if you'd like. But since we're working in the command line, let's continue to do this. So it's very similar to the username, but instead of user.name, we'll do user.email and set the value. So now we're back in our command prompt. I'm going to go ahead and make this change. So we'll do user.email quote, and I'll put an email address in here. And then again, if we want to see that it's there it is. All right, so now we have GitHub installed. We've configured our username and our email. And so now what we need to do is confirm that we can actually connect to GitHub this way, and we'll try to clone a project. So to test this, we'll go ahead and try to clone a public project using Git that we've just installed. And here I'm on Fishtown Analytics, their GitHub page for dbt. And what we'll do here is try to clone this, which means download it locally. I'm going to copy this here. We're going to code copy. We'll go here to the command prompt. I'm going to change directories into documents. And what I actually did here is created a new folder called GitHub demo. And within here, we can see there's nothing in here currently. So let's actually change to GitHub demo, typo. And now we're in here, and what we'll do is run the command git clone and then paste that value, which is the location of that public project that we're trying to get a copy of locally. Enter. Cloning, and we can see it's working. So that means it connected to GitHub. It found all those files and cloned it locally. If we go in here, now we can see it. And we have all of the files that are up here on this project. And now we have a copy. We can create our own branch, which is, you can see here, there's 109 branches currently for this project, and start to interact with it. We can make our own changes locally, use Git to create a new branch, move the changes up here, and do what's called a pull request, which means ask some people to review it, add their comments, and perhaps it will get what's called merged into this file for everybody else to use. And these kind of things we'll touch on now in future videos, but at this point, you're all set up with Git. You'll still have to create your own GitHub account, which is technically separate than Git itself. Like the name says, it's a hub of all of these things, ultimately based on that Git concept. Now you're on your way, and we'll continue to build on this throughout the rest of these videos.